हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ मिस्टर वीडी जाधव फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री एट एच एम कॉलेज नासिक टू। टुडे दिस इज अवर फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑफ फिफ्थ चैप्टर मास स्पेक्ट्रोमेट्री एलसीएमएस इंटरफेस एंड एप्लीकेशंस। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी डिस्कस स्ट्रक्चरल इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रोस्प्रे आयोनाइजेशन। The atmospheric pressure chemical ionization interface, etc. So, in the previous lecture, we see the appearance of electrospray spectrum. Let us start first structural information from electrospray ionization. In the previous section, the generation and processing of molecular weight data from electrospray spectra have been described. The other great strength of mass spectrometry is its ability to generate structural information from the analyte. Under investigation, it has already been pointed out that electrospray is the softest ionization process used in mass spectrometry. That is, the transfer of ions to the gas phase is a low energy process leading almost exclusively to the production of molecular species. There are two ways in which structural information can be generated when electrospray ionization is being used. The first, which may be applied to ions generated by any method of ionization, is tandem mass spectrometry, which is described in another point in another chapter. The second known variously as a cone voltage or in source fragmentation is similar to repeller induced fragmentation in thermospray and is a feature of ionization techniques in which ions are fragmented within the source of the mass spectrometer by the application of a voltage between nozzle and skimmer. See in the figure 4.7, this figure 4.7 already discussed in previous lecture. The application of this voltage increases the velocity of ions exiting the cone into the relatively high pressure region between this and the skimmer, approximately 10 raised to minus 2 torr. 1 torr is equal to 133.3 Pascal. The probability of collision between ions and residual gas molecules is significant. And with the increased energy now purchased by the analyte ions, fragmentation is much more likely. The amount of energy imparted to the ions by the voltage is proportional to the number of charges on the ion, and therefore multiply charged ion often give fragmentation than their less highly charged counterparts. From an analytical perspective, the fact that ions of different charge states are likely to fragment differently may yield extra and often complementary information. A significant difference between MSMS and cone voltage fragmentation is that in the former, a specific ion of interest is chosen and its fragmentation studied in isolation. In addition, a number of different MSMS experiment yielding different types of information are available. Cone voltage fragmentation, on the other hand, is equivalent to one of the MSMS experiments. That is, the product's ion scan and the produces fragmentation of all species generated in the source. Repeller induced fragmentation with the thermospray interface. Since a characteristic of electrospray ionization is that it usually produces a number of ions corresponding to different charge states of the analyte molecule, the spectra may be more difficult to interpret. For this reason, MSMS mass spectrometry, if available, is usually the preferred method for obtaining structural information. The product ion spectra generated by multiply charge ions differ in one significant respect from those generated by singly charged ion, in that the product ions may not be of the same charge state as the precursor ion. The mass to charge value of the product ion could therefore be greater than that of the precursor form which it originated, and this must be taken into account when setting up the mass spectrometer to acquire the spectral data. This is also of significance when interpretation of the data is attempted. Here in this figure 4.9, already discussed in previous lecture, that is electrospray spectra of a protein after A is the after transformation and B after maximum entropy processing. In figure 4.20 shows the product ion spectrum of the doubly charged molecular ion of the peptide glue fibrinopeptide B at mass to charge ratio 786. This 786.2 generated by electrospray ionization, displaying a number of ions at mass to charge ratios above that of the precursor. In this case, because it is known that the precursor is doubly charged, this must be singly charged, and the mass difference between them are directly related to the loss of amino acid residues. This spectrum enables the full sequence of the peptide to be confirmed, where the precursor to have more charges, the charge state of the product ions, and thus the relationship between them would be less obvious and require a more detailed interpretation. The greater the number of charges on the precursor, then the more difficult is the spectrum likely to be to interpret. Here in this figure 4.20, product ion MSMS spectrum from the doubly charged molecular ion of the peptide glue fibrinogen B generated during electrospray ionization. This is literature published by Thermo Finnegan, Hemel, Hempstead, UK, and reproduced with permission. The implications of charge must also be considered when constant neutral loss spectra are obtained because no longer is the loss necessarily of neutral spaces. Example, the loss of neutral CO carbon monoxide mass 28 from a singly charged ion mass to charge 250 yields an ion of mass to charge 222, while from a doubly charged ion of mass to charge 125 it would yield an ion of mass to charge 111, that is 222 divided by 2. The loss of CO plus from a doubly charged ion of mass to charge ratio 125 would yield an ion of mass to charge ratio 222. The strength of MSMS is its ability to select a single ion and study this in isolation. And for singly charged ions, the resolution of the mass spectrometer is usually sufficient to allow this. For multiply charged ions, as discussed previously, the resolution required to allow the selection of single ion is often greater than that available from the mass spectrometer being used. What is observed in these circumstances is the MSMS spectrum of the isotopic cluster, and this needs to be taken into account when interpretation of the resulting spectra is attempted. Electrospray is an unusual mass spectrometry technique in that it allows the study of the three-dimensional structure of compounds, particularly proteins, in solution, as it is believed that this is relatively unchanged. When ions are transferred to the vapor phase, this type of application will be discussed in more detail in another chapter, but attention is drawn at this point to the previous comments regarding the effect that the HPLC conditions such as pH may have on the appearance of an electrospray spectrum, and conformational deductions that may be made from them. Summary of electrospray interfaces. Summary for the electrospray interface. The advent of the electrospray interface has allowed the full potential of LCMS to be achieved. It is not probably the most widely used LCMS interface, as it is applicable to a wide range of polar and thermally labile analytes of both low and high molecular weight, and it is compatible with a wide range of HPLC conditions. Next, advantages. Ionization occurs directly from solution and consequently allows ionic and thermally labile compounds to be studied. Next, mobile phase flow rates from nanoliter per minute to in excess of 1 ml per minute can be used with appropriate hardware, thus allowing conventional and microbore columns to be employed. Next, electrospray ionization, in contrast to the majority of other ionization methods employed in mass spectrometry, produces predominantly multiply charge ions of the intact solute molecules. This effectively extends the mass range of the mass spectrometer and allows the study of molecules with molecular weights well outside its normal range. Next, for high molecular weight materials, an electrospray spectrum provides a number of independent molecular weight determination from a single spectrum and thus increased precision. Disadvantages of electrospray interface. First one, electrospray is not applicable to non-polar or low polarity compounds. Next, the mass spectrum produced from an analyte in terms of mass to charge ratio range of the ions observed and their relative intensity depend upon a number of factors and spectra obtained using different experimental conditions may therefore differ considerably in appearance. This may or may not have implications on the analytical investigations being undertaken. Although the molecular weight information that may be extracted from these spectra, however, is independent of these differences. Next, suppression effects may be observed and the direct analysis of mixtures is not always possible. This has potential implications for co-eluting analytes in LC-MS. Next, electrospray is a soft ionization method producing intact molecular spaces and structural information is not usually available. Electrospray sources are capable of producing structural information from cone voltage fragmentation, but these spectra are not always easily interpretable. Experimentally, the best solution is to use a mass spectrometer capable of MS-MS operation, but this has not inconsequential financial implications. Next, type of interface, that is the atmospheric pressure chemical ionization interface. The electrospray interface described in the previous section enables mass spectra to be obtained from highly polar and ionic compounds. Atmospheric pressure chemical ionization, that is capital APCI, is another of the technique in which the stream of liquid emerging from an HPLC column is dispersed into small droplets. In this case, by the combination of heat and nebulizing gas, as shown in figure 4.21. As such, atmospheric pressure chemical ionization shares many common features with electrospray ionization and thermospray, which have been discussed previously. The differences between the techniques are the methods used for droplet generation and the mechanism of subsequent ion formation. These differences affect the analytical capabilities, in particular the range of polarity of analyte which may be ionized and the liquid flow rates that may be accommodated. Two, atmospheric pressure chemical ionization interface systems are shown in figure 4.22, with the major difference between them being the use of heated capillary for dissolution and droplet transport in the second of these, that is 4.22b. ESI. Here the HPLC effluent is passed through a pneumatic nebulizer where the droplets are both generated and dissolved. The spray soap form then passes through a heated region where the vapor is dried. The neutral species thus produced are then passed through a corona discharge. The latter occurs when the field at the tip of the electrode is sufficiently high to ionize the gas surrounding it, but insufficiently high to cause a spark, where ionization of the analyte is effected by chemical ionization type processes with the vaporized solvent acting as the reagent gas. The technique is capable of dealing with flow rates between 0.5 and 2 ml per minute, so making it directly compatible with 4.6 mm columns and is much more tolerant to a range of buffers. The similarity of the hardware required for APCI to that required for electrospray may be seen from comparing figure 4.9 and 4.22, and makes changing between the techniques convenient from a practical point of view. The complementary nature of the two ionization techniques may therefore be readily utilized. This is the figure 4.21, schematic of an atmospheric pressure chemical ionization probe. And this is figure 4.22, schematic of two different designs of atmospheric pressure chemical ionization LCMS interfaces from application literature published by A. Thermo Finnegan and B. Micromass UK Limited, Manchester, UK. Reproduce with permission. Here, heated nebulizer, corona pin, heated block, lens assembly, RF lens, mass spectrometer. Here, mass spectrometer. Here also mass spectrometer. This is skimmer, heated capillary. This is heated capillary, corona needle, and vaporizer. In this place, there is vaporizer. This is A, this is B. Next, the mechanism of atmospheric pressure chemical ionization. Chemical ionization is an efficient and relatively mild method of ionization which takes place at a relatively high pressure when compared to other methods of ionization used in mass spectrometry. The kinetics of the ion molecules reactions involved would suggest that ultimate sensitivity should be obtained when ionization takes place at atmospheric pressure. It is not possible, however, to use the conventional source of electrons, a heated metallic filament, to effect the initial ionization of a reagent gas at such pressures, and an alternative such as 63 nickel, a beta minus emitter, or a corona discharge must be employed. The corona discharge is used in commercially available atmospheric pressure chemical ionization systems, as it gives greater sensitivity and is less hazardous than the alternative. The process is leading to the ionization of the analyte at atmospheric pressure are similar to those described previously in relation to chemical ionization. In that ions produced by the interaction of the electrons with the surrounding gas undergo a number of reactions leading to the generation of reactive ions which interact with the analyte molecules present. The reagent species in the positive ion may be considered to be protonated solvent ions and in the negative ion made O2-, its hydrates and clusters as with conventional chemical ionization. This is a very mild form of ionization leading to molecular species with little or no fragmentation, that is M plus protonic fragmentation, molecular weight protonic fragmentation, M plus H plus in bracket M plus H outside plus and M minus H in bracket M minus H outside bracket minus, that is anionic and protonic fragmentation. This is not, however, always the case. The use of chromatographic modifiers may change the composition of the chemical ionization plasma to such a state that, as in chemical ionization and thermospray, other ions may be formed. For example, the presence of ammonium acetate may lead to M plus NH4 plus, that is acetate ion, and M plus CH3COO minus ions. In the positive and negative ion modes, respectively, the chemistry of the analyte may also have an effect, as has been discussed for ESI electrospray ionization with, for example, the spectra of fluorine extracted from soot particles yielding an M plus radical molecular species. In addition to the formation of these ions of direct analytical utility, atmospheric pressure chemical ionization leads to the formation of ion clusters involving solvent molecules. Since these tend to make interpretation more difficult, they need to be removed, and this may be accomplished either by the use of a curtain gas or by cone voltage fragmentation, which is also applicable to atmospheric pressure chemical ionization, APCR. From this description, it can be seen that APCI is a gas phase process, and it may seem that this technique is only applicable to the same range of compounds. That may be studied by electrospray ionization and chemical ionization. That is, those that are volatile and thermally stable. Atmospheric pressure chemical ionization is, however, equally applicable to more polar compounds, and this has led to its use in combination with HPLC. Atmospheric pressure chemical ionization ionizes most efficiently compounds with low to moderately high polarities, and in this respect is complementary to electrospray, which gives the best sensitivity for ionic compounds. The APCI ionization regime is much more harsh than electrostatic ionization, and this precludes its use for the study of large biomolecules. With the mass limit for atmospheric pressure, chemical ionization being generally considered as below 2000 dalton. Having said this, as will be shown later, the technique may still be used for the analysis of many thermally labile compounds without their decomposition, and small peptides have been studied. When ions are present in solution, nebulization produces charged droplet from which ions may be emitted directly into the gas phase by ion evaporation. The formation of ions in this way is by a totally different mechanism to that of atmospheric pressure chemical ionization, and is termed aerospray, capital AES. An LCMS interface based solely on the aerospray principle alone has not yet been made available commercially. The overall change on any droplet depend upon the statistical distribution of cations and anions. Within it, some will have a positive charge and some a negative charge. As with conventional chemical ionization, positive ion formation is favored by the presence of strong gas phase acids, and negative ion formation by the presence of strong gas phase bases. The production of a distribution of charged droplet applies to thermospray, aerospray, and atmospheric pressure chemical ionization is one of the major differences between these techniques and electrospray / ion spray, electrospray or ion spray interfaces. Next, summary for atmospheric pressure chemical ionization. APCI is a complementary to electrospray in that it allows spectra to be obtained from non-polar and only slightly polar compounds. There is a great deal of commonality in the hardware used for the production of atmospheric pressure chemical ionization and electrospray spectra, and the combination of the two techniques allows a high proportion of HPLC eluates to be studied. Advantages of APCI. APCI produces ions from solution, and while the analyte experiences more heat than with electrospray, compounds with a degree of thermal instability may be studied without their decomposition. Next, APCI is best applied to compounds with low to moderately high polarities. Next, APCI is a soft ionization technique which usually enables the molecular weight of the analyte under study to be determined. Next, APCI is able to deal with fluorides up to 2 ml per minute and is consequently directly compatible with 4.6 mm HPLC columns. APCI is more tolerant to the presence of buffers in the mobile head stream than is electrospray ionization techniques. Next, APCI is more tolerant to changes in experimental conditions than electrospray ionization, and a range of mobile phases including gradient elution may therefore be accommodated using a single set of experimental conditions. These all are the advantages of atmospheric pressure chemical ionization or APCI. Next, disadvantages of APCI. First, APCI spectra can contain ions from adducts of the analyte with the HPLC mobile phase or organic modifiers such as ammonium acetate that may be present. The presence of ions such as M+, NH4+, and M+, CH3COO- may hinder interpretation of the spectra obtained. Next, disadvantage is structural information is not usually available unless cone voltage fragmentation of MS-MS is used. Next, APCI is not able to function effectively at very low flow rates. Next, APCI is not suitable for analytes that are charged in solution. All these are the atmospheric pressure chemical ionization techniques, their mechanism, their introduction, summary, advantages, disadvantages, etc. Thank you.